Hey, math class. Here is another video. This is a little bit different format, so please let me know what you think of it. Today we're going to be talking about perimeter and area, and what's the difference between those two. So the first thing that we're going to talk about is perimeter. Perimeter is simply the distance around the outside edge of a flat object. So for example, here we have a rectangle, right? And as you can see, this rectangle is 5 inches long along this side and 2 inches wide over here. So again, we have the length and the width, okay? And all we're going to do is add up those totals. So we're going to assume, since it's a rectangle, that this side right here is going to be 2 inches and this side up here will be 5 inches. And so then all we'll do is say 2 plus 2 for both of the short edges, plus 5 for the two long edges. And if we add that up, we find out that it's 14 inches. So our perimeter, we could say, of this rectangle is 14 inches. Let's look at another example of perimeter, because perimeter is not just limited to rectangles. I could also find the perimeter of this triangle, and it's simply done the same way. I look at how long each of my sides are and simply add them up. So 6 plus 3 plus 5 equals 14 feet. So that will tell me how long this triangle is all the way around the outside edge here. Here's another perimeter example. This happens to be kind of more of a square, right? It's the same size on all four sides of the square. Sorry, I was looking at three and I said it instead of four. It's the same size on all sides, on all four sides, okay? So again, all I do is I add them up, 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3, and I end up with 12 centimeters. That's the length, the distance around, all the way around this square. Okay, so that was perimeter. Now we're going to talk about area. Area is the amount of surface space that a flat object has. And the important thing to think about with this, it's reported in square units. And we'll kind of talk about what that means a little bit later here too. And we simply find it by multiplying the length times the width of a square or a rectangle. So, gosh, how are we going to remember the difference between these two things? So let's sort of think of a room, okay? Like a room in your house or even the classroom that you are sitting in. If you're measuring the baseboard of the room, so kind of the edging that goes around the bottom of the floor, that's the perimeter. But when you measure the carpet of a room, how much flooring you would need, that is the area. So hopefully this will sort of remind you of what perimeter is and what area is. Okay, so area, if I have a rectangle and it's 5 inches long and 4 inches wide, so it has a length of 5 inches and a width of 4 inches, all I'm going to do is simply multiply these together. 5 times 4, which will give me 20 square inches. Or I could also write it like this, inches squared. And that little 2 right up here, that means squared. So that's an appropriate way to write it as well. Well, how come 5 by 4 is 20? Here's a picture of why that is. So here I have 5 inches long and 4 inches wide, and you can see I can actually count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. So you see how there are 20 square inches within this rectangle? That's really what you're finding when you're looking at the area. Oh, I went the wrong way. You can also just count up the units too. So if the units are shown, especially in funny shapes, that will help you to find the area too. So as you see here, this is a 1-inch square by a 1-inch square. How many squares do I count in this funny shape? Well, again, I'm just going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Oh, how funny. That is 20 square inches as well. Okay. And I got that because I can see those 20 square inches inside the shape. I can count them. Oh, I keep going the wrong way. Okay, so let's try a practice problem with area, okay, and perimeter. Joe wants to landscape his backyard by adding a fence around the edge and sod on the ground. His backyard is 18 feet by 20 feet. So how much fencing will he need and how much sod will he need? So fencing, a fence is going to go all the way around the edges of this piece of property, right? So we're really finding perimeter. And sod, that's that funny kind of roll out grass, you know, that would be kind of the surface area. It's like the carpet of his backyard. So for that, we would need to find the area. Okay, so let's figure out the answer. Here's our picture again. And just a reminder, perimeter, we're simply going to add up all the sides. And the area, we're going to do length times width. Okay, so perimeter, let's do that first. I have 20 feet in length, 18 feet width, and I'm going to assume that this side is 20 feet as well, and this side right here is 18 feet. So all I'm going to do is add them up. 20 plus 20 plus 18 plus 18 equals 76 feet. So he would need 76 feet of fencing all the way around his property. Okay, how about for area? How much sod would he need to buy and roll out? So again, here's 20 feet my length and 18 feet my width. So I'm going to say 20 times 18, length times width, and that equals 360 square feet. So in order to fill in this whole area, he will need 360 square feet of sod. So hopefully this helps to kind of clear up the difference between area and perimeter, and we're going to do some practice problems in just a second.